Hi there. I want to share with you how this nib burns. This is referred to as the ballpoint nib, and I want to show you what techniques it tends to naturally burn best.
Hey Pyro, I'm Gianni Lisenby, founder of burnsavvy.com and your Pyro professor. And this video series is Woodburning Tips and Their Uses, Wire Nib Edition. If you are looking for the solid point edition, that's already over on my YouTube channel. Feel free to hop over there and check out that playlist. And if you want more videos like this one, remember to smash the like button and subscribe button, and then press the bell so you never miss a video.
As a reminder, the point of these videos are not to show you what you can do with this nib, because I believe that you can do almost any technique with almost any nib if you try hard enough. So I'm intentionally not trying hard, okay? I want you to see what this nib likes to do naturally. Now, I am using a Walnut Hollow Creative Burner, and I am burning at a level 7. The first test is the lines. And I'm noticing that for straight lines, unless you have a really steady hand, you're gonna have to do a lot of touch-up. And maybe not even a lot of touch-up. I would say it's okay. Probably not the best used for straight lines, but it can be done. Now with dots, these are perfect. As you can imagine, being a perfectly round circle, these make beautiful dots, whether you're moving slowly to get those darker dots or you're moving quickly to get the lighter, tinier dots. This is ideal for dots. With the curves, I noticed that it actually took the curves pretty nicely, and the smaller curves were really good. Actually, the smaller curves were even better with the ballpoint than they were with the writing nib. With the circles, I found it to be also quite good for the circles. So for curves and circles, I would say your ballpoint is a fabulous option. When it comes to lettering, I found that it took the curves really nicely. So this is really good for those calligraphy type prints or the cursive typewriting. I actually prefer the writing nib if I'm going to do cursive about this size, but if I'm going to do really small cursive, I'll get a small ballpoint, and that will work better than the writing nib in my experience. But in the test, it did just fine. Also, when you're doing these block lettering, again, it was pretty good, but I think that you could do better with something that had a little bit more of a crisp edge rather than this ballpoint, which has a nice round edge. When it comes to shading, once again, I did some straight up and down lines and slowly moved faster to create a gradient. And then I did some swirly lines that are the circular scumbling motion to create a gradient, right? Different textures. And I found that it was okay. It's not bad. It does take some work, and so it's not necessarily an ideal use, but it's definitely a use that you could use for the ballpoint. So overall, for this test, I would say that the ballpoint is okay for lines, fantastic for dots, great for curves and circles, okay for lettering, and okay for shading.
If this was helpful, you should definitely jump into the free 5-day beginner woodburning art challenge going on, where you're going to learn woodburning tips, techniques, and fundamentals that are going to help you get the clean, crisp lines and beautiful burned art that you've been craving. Join us at woodburningartchallenge.com/join to jump into the party. I'll see you there. Later, Pyro.